पर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकन्नामरूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वनिर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेवाहं नमस्तोऽन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। द्वितीय तरंगा वी आर लुकिंग एट दी रिस्पॉन्सेस टू द आक्षेपा डन बाय दी पूर्व पक्षी वेयर बाय देयर इज अ क्वेश्चनिंग एज टू देयर आर नो अधिकारीज अवेलेबल व्हाई वुड यू राइट दिस काइंड ऑफ अ ग्रंथा एंड इवन इफ देयर आर अधिकारीज स्टिल देयर आर बेटर ग्रंथास देन दिस दे कैन बी studied instead of this grantha. All these were answered and in the last patha we saw the akshepa answered which was this grantha's just a second yeah so there are divisions made as to satyapi mumukshau tasya moksha granthe pravritti anupapattehe tadarambha viphala there There are divisions made as to whether asmin granthe mumukshoho pravrutya bhava karanam kim asya granthasya moksha sadhanatva bhava va kim va itopi utkrushtasya sadhanatamasya granthantarasya satvam va uta vedanta granthesu yani sadhanani shamadamadani uktani adhikari visheshanatvena tadrusha shamadamadi sadhana chatushte sahitasya jnana sampadana yogya adhikarinah ekasya api abhava. So these have been refuted. All three. Then, in the end, what has been said is this Prouda Granthas, last, this Prouda Granthas which are there compared to this Grantha, they are much better. Bhashya, Tika, all these. Upanishad, Gita, Sutra, and then Bhashya, Tika, Ityadi are available. Why would anyone study this? There, the answer was given as there are lot of adhikaris lacking. You are right about lot of adhikaris lacking. There are only few. Among those few also, those who have mumukshutvam but do not have sadhana chatushte sampatti which is needed for the utkrushta granthas, those are lacking. Thereby, this grantha has prayojana. Further, these, whether there are many, among those also, there aren't many mumukshus who are adhikaris, even for this grantha, or not even a single. That kind of a division was made. Adye ishtapattihi, because we don't want, we are not looking for many to cater to. Even if there is one adhikari, that is sufficient. Therefore, na dvitiya also. It is foolish to say that there are no adhikaris, everyone is a mumukshu, and then some who do not have mala, vikshepa and avarana, meaning papa, chanchalya and swarupa ajnana, those who do not have, see swarupa ajnana here does not necessarily mean aikya. Aikya is known, that is not the going away of swarupa ajnana or avarana. Avarana only means that one does not know one's not being connected to the body mind sense complex and thereby that person becomes an adhikari. He knows that I am attached to this sharira now, but I am different from the sharira. Thereby the karma will take away the mala, शुभकर्मणा मलस्य उपासनया विक्षेपस्य ज्ञानेन स्वरूप आवरणस्य च निवृत्तिर जायते एव देयर बाय दिस ग्रंथ विल एटलीस्ट केटर टू वन अस्य अस्मिन् ग्रंथे जायते एव प्रवृत्ति देयरफॉर देयर विल बी अ प्रवृत्ति इन दिस ग्रंथ एंड इट विल केटर टू एटलीस्ट वन पर्सन इट वुड बी फूलिश टू से दैट इट वुडंट केटर टू एनी वन फर्दर This Pamara Vishayinoho Lakshanam. The division has been made as to these Adhikaris or what kind of people are there. Among them, then we look at who is the Adhikari. So they are defined. Pamara and Vishayi. Vishayasya Stiti Vishayi. But who is Pamara now? And whom does this Grantha really cater to? Yattu Uktam Sarvepi Vishay Sukhasakta Eva न कोपि नित्य निरतिशय सुखम वांछति इति तन्न नाउ दिस ऑब्जेक्शन विच वॉज रेज अर्लियर अमॉन्ग दीज मेनी ऑप्शन क्रिएटेड बिफोर दैट देर वॉज अनदर ऑब्जेक्शन विच सेड दैट एवरी वन इज लुकिंग फॉर विषय सुख नो बडी इज इंटरेस्टेड इन दिस परमानंद सुख विच इज स्वरूपात्मक देर इट वॉज आंसर्ड दैट एवरी वन इज अ मुमुक्षु एवरी वन इज लुकिंग फॉर आनंद नोइंगली और अनोइंगली And in that sense, everyone is a mumukshu. Now, specifically, everyone looks for Vishayananda means that everyone is a Vishayi. If everyone is a Vishayi, then nobody will want to study this Grantha. Nobody would want Nitya Niratishaya Sukham. This is the idea there by talking about a Vishayi. And Pamaras, anyway, Pamaras are basically. It is defined here, so I'll explain only through the definition. General meaning is a dullard. A dullard, even stupid or other meanings are there, but we'll take it as a dullard. Dullard so much so, from the perspective of the Shastra, anyone who does not look at Shastra as a Pramana or does not even do anything related to the Shastra, that person is considered as a Pamara here in this Grantha specifically. सो यत्तु उक्तम सर्वेपि विषय सुखासक्ताः एव न कोपि नित्य निरतिशय सुखम वांछति इति तन्न एवरीवन इज अट्रैक्टेड टुवर्ड्स दी हैप्पीनेस जनरेटेड बाय दी विषयास ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड देयरफॉर नॉट इवन अ सिंगल पर्सन डिजायर्स नित्य निरतिशय सुख हाईएस्ट हैप्पीनेस I am okay with this kind of a happiness, whatever I regularly get. I don't want highest happiness. This is the objection. But is that true? People know that I won't get Nitya Sukha. How much ever I indulge in an object, still I won't get Nitya Sukha. And it won't completely leave me satisfied anyway. This is the reason it may appear that they do not want Nitya Niratishaya Sukha, but all that everyone wants is Nitya Niratishaya Sukha. They do not know the means to get them. That is the issue. The hunt for Sukha is for Niratishaya Sukha and it is for Nitya Sukha only. So that is not true. Why? Now, Pamaraha Vishayi जिज्ञासु मुक्तश्चेति लोके चतुर्विधाः पुरुषाः देयर आर फोर टाइप्स ऑफ पीपल पामरा विषयी जिज्ञासु एंड मुक्त मुक्त वी नो जिज्ञासु आल्सो वी नो ज्ञातुम इच्छु जिज्ञासु विषयी आल्सो विषयस्य अस्ति इति विषयी हु सीक्स अ विषय हु हैज विषयस हु हैज विषय आसक्ति पामरा इज अ डलर्ड तत्र अमंग दोस विहित प्रतिषेधेषु ऐहिक विषय भोगेशु आसक्त सन शास्त्रीय संस्कार शून्य यह स पामर हु हैज एब्सोल्युटली नो संस्कार इन शास्त्र सो हु आर दीज दोज हु हैव नॉट स्टडीड एनी शास्त्र दे डू नॉट नो अबाउट सच शास्त्र एग्जिस्टिंग मिलेच्छास दे आर विहित प्रतिषेधेशु ऐहिक विषय भोगेशु आसक्त सन being attracted towards vishaya bhogas which are worldly because they don't know of the other world everything is here charvakas they don't care about shastra. So vihita pratishetha, they do not care, for I can do anything I want. I have free will. I will use it the way I want it. I do not care who tells me what to do. They are Pamaras. They do not even know that such shastras exist. There is something prescribed, something prohibited, because they are completely attached to the Vishayas, raga dvesha driven. Second category, shastra anusari vishaya bhogan bhunjanah san ihamutra ihamutrartha phalabhoga vaptaye karma kurvano vishayi. So one who, see, vishayi, generally we think the first category, pamara, we think are vishayis. That is not true. Pamaras are those who do not care for shastras. Vishayis are those who care for shastras and they follow the shastra, shastra anusari. Following the shastras, vishaya bhogan bhunjanah, they indulge in the vishayas, but in keeping with the shastra, they are also vishayis. They may be earning punya, but that is all that they are doing. They want sukha here and hereafter. They are also searching for sukha. Earlier is also searching for sukha in the world, in the worldly objects. This person, Vishayi, goes along with the Shastra and says, I'll get more sukha if I earn punya and avoid papa. To attain that kind of a phala, which gives more sukha, this person, Vishayi, keeps on indulging. Who is a jijnyasu? Do jijnyasu lakshanam yastu shastriyottama samskara balad adhyatmadi sachastra shravanam karoti tasya vakshyamana ritya viveko jayate tatha vivekah yasya bhavati saha eva jijnyasu. So jijnyasu here jnyatum ichchu, but he has started the shravana. So jijnyasu jnyatum ichchu, and he does not, you know, just remain with this ichcha. He follows through that ichcha, does shravana, shastra shravana, satshastra shravanam adhyatmadi. So everything related to the atma, this viveki, because he has atma anatma viveka, he wants to understand the atma. Anatma is what he knows. Of course, atma cannot be known unless it is differentiated from anatma. But his focus is on atma, not on anatma. As soon as, you know, people start talking about srishti prakriya, then they are interested to know what exactly happened, how exactly it happened in srishti. They are all srishti chintakaha. Similarly, if you start differentiating between atma and anatma, when anatma is talked, then people are more interested in anatma than atma. However, this jijnyasu is not like that. Jijnyasu is interested. When he does viveka, he knows what is more important. He holds on to the teaching which is connected to atma and does not waste time in anatma. So how many, you know, I want to know exactly what goes into what in sukshma sharira. All that is fine, but that is not the focus area. This is all going to be discarded as mithya. The reason it is being given reality is because we think it is real. Shastra is doing hand-holding. We should not get lost in anatma. So yastriya shastriya uttama samskara balad. He has uttama samskaras as per the Vaidika samskaras, as per the Vedas, as per the dharma shastras which are derived from Vedas. Thereby, they are driven to adhyatma and they satshastra sharanam karoti. Singular, so yaha karoti tasya vakshyamane ritya viveko jayate. Then this atma anatma viveka jayate. He knows, and then it becomes more and more dridha. So that viveka, tatha viveka yasya bhavati, yasya asti saha eva jijnyasu. Further, तत्र वैषयिकं सुखं सर्वमपि दुःखमेव इति प्रथमतो विवेको भवति. सो हाउ दिस विवेक, वक्षमाणे रीत्या, इट इज गोइंग टू बी टॉक्ड अबाउट हाउ दिस विवेका कम्स अबाउट, एंड ही इज Vakshamana Ritya, he is describing that. Sadhu is describing as to how this Viveka comes about stepwise. So we can fill in gaps. If something is missing, we can fill in gaps. Tatra vaishayikam sukam sarvam api dukkham meva. Iti prathamato viveko bhavati. First step towards viveka is, Shruti says that, parikshalokan karmachitan brahmano nirvedamayat nastya krutakrutena. Krutena karmana akrutaha nasti. Now this is the stepwise process to reach that kind of a viveka. By karma, I am not going to get nitya sukha, which is akruta. Nitya sukha is my sarupa. So this is the conclusion which one has to arrive at. How does he arrive at? So Mundaka Upanishad says, pariksha lokan, lokyate iti lokaha. That which is experience, karmani vitpatti. That which is experience is loka. So experiences are analyzed by this person. Having analyzed the experiences, however young or old this person is, everyone has all sorts of experiences. It may not be in the same mix, but still there is all sorts of experiences are there for each and every one of us, more or less. If we analyze them, then we can also land on the same conclusion that the Upanishad talks about. I am unable to hold on to my sukha. It is not nitya. And even in the indulgence of the same object, I don't get the same sukha every time. It leaves me more and more wanting. So the same level of indulgence wouldn't give me the same sukha next time. So it is dukkha mishritam. That is the idea. It is addictive. It is dukkha mishritam. It leaves me unsatisfied really and does not stay. Sukha does not stay even while experiencing there is dukkha. If I separate out from that vishaya, then I have dukkha. Thinking that I'll separate out from this, right now I'm experiencing sukha, when I have this vishaya, it will go away, it will not stay. You know, that itself will generate some dukkha even during experiencing sukha. So many flaws are there. So tatra vaishikam sukham sarvam api dukkham eva iti prathamato viveko bhavati. Tatha hi vishaya sukham sarvam anityam eva. All the vishaya sukha is anitya. Vishayendriya sanyogajatvena agama paitvat. So for that hetu is given. Why is it anityam? Because Vishaya and Indriya Sanyoga is there. Once there is a connection, Sambandha between Vishaya and Indriya, whichever way it comes into contact, Vishaya and Indriya come into contact with each other, then something is Jata, something is born, that Sukha is Adimat. Adimat Sukham. It has a beginning. Since it has a beginning, it also has an end. There is nothing which has a beginning and does not have an end. Whatever is created in time will wither away in time. Thereby, this sukha, which is vishaya sukha, born out of sanyoga of the indriya with the vishaya, thereby is also antamat. It will have an end. Thereby anitya. Agama paitvat, having, because it comes and goes. Vishaya comes in, there is a sambandha of indriya, it generates some sukha, and since that sukha is born, it will go away. When the vishaya sambandha goes away, or it stops to give me the same sukha, for whatever reasons, driven by my ragadvesha, or the very characteristics of Vishaya is such that it will become nauseatic by overconsumption. You have to rest your Indriyas. Indriyas cannot take it anymore. You cannot keep on watching movies. You cannot keep on listening to music. Even if you like it, Indriyas wear out. Therefore, सुखा इज अनित्यम विषय सुख, सुखम च वैषयिकम स्वावस्थिति समय अपि यत्किंचित दुखानुषंगीयव भवति। देर इज सम कॉन्टैक्ट विद दुख ऑल्सो बिकॉज इट इज नॉट प्योर सुखा। सुखा इज रियली नॉट इन द विषय। सुखा इज द स्वरूप सुखा विच बिकम्स मैनिफेस्ट इन द अंतकरणा एज एन ऑब्जेक्टिफाइबल हैप्पीनेस विच वॉज अदरवाइज नॉट ऑब्जेक्टिफाइबल, विच वॉज नॉट एक्सपीरियंसेबल। इट बिकम्स एक्सपीरियंसेबल ड्यू टू द निमित्त ऑफ द विषय। हाउ सो? बाय टेकिंग अवे द डिजायर फॉर द विषय। दैट डिजायर डज नॉट गो अवे कंप्लीटली, सिंस दैट डिजायर इज वेरी वेल इम्प्रेस्ड अपॉन द अंतकरण। इट डजेंट गो अवे कंप्लीटली, इवन वाइल आई एक्सपीरियंस इट देर इज सम मिक्स ऑफ दैट डिजायर एंड देयर बाय ड्यूरिंग द एक्सपीरियंस इटसेल्फ इट इज दुख मिश्रित। यत्किंचित दुख अनुषंगी एव भवति। देर इज सम अनुषंग, देर इज सम कनेक्शन विद दुख विच डजेंट गो अवे। देर बाय दैट सुख अनुभव इज नॉट कंप्लीट इवन वेन देर इज एन अनुभव। देर फोर देर आर ग्रेडेशंस। नॉट एवरी वन फील्स द सेम सुख विद द सेम विषय एंड द सेम पर्सन ऑल्सो डज नॉट फील द सेम सुख विथ मल्टीपल इंटेलिजेंसेस विद द सेम विषय। देन स्वविनाशेन अपि दुख हेतुर्भवति। स्वविनाश इज दिस वैषयिकम, वैषयिकम सुखम स्वविनाशेन। दैट वैषयिक सुख गोज अवे बिकॉज इट इज अनित्य, बिकॉज इट इज बॉर्न इट विल गो अवे। एंड आफ्टर विनाश ऑल्सो ड्यू टू इट विनाश दुख हेतुर्भवति। ओ आई हैड सम अनुभव, समटाइम्स पीपल फील दैट ओ आई डू नॉट गेट दिस अगेन, इट वॉज सच अ यू नो इट ब्रॉट सो मच ऑफ हैप्पीनेस। नाउ समटाइम्स आई फील यू नो आई नेवर हैड दिस, आई नेवर हैड दिस एक्सपीरियंस, आई शुड नॉट हैव इंडल्ज बिकॉज नाउ आई मिस इट सो मच। आई वुडंट हैव मिस्ड इट हैड आई नॉट हैड दैट एक्सपीरियंस। आई वॉज बेटर ऑफ अर्लियर, यू नो, नॉट नोइंग इट, नॉट कमिंग इन टू कॉन्टैक्ट विद सच अ पर्सन और सच अ थिंग वॉज इवन बेटर। आई मिस दैट पर्सन, यू नो, और आई मिस दैट ऑब्जेक्ट, वॉट एवर इट इज। सो समटाइम्स इट बिकम्स मोर टैक्सिंग ऑन वन सेल्फ टू कम इन टू कॉन्टैक्ट विद द ऑब्जेक्ट एंड लूज इट। किंच वैषयिकम सुखम अनुभव दशायाम अपि इतः परम ईदृशम सुखम क्षीयते किल इति व्याकुलतोत्पादनेन अपि दुःख निदानम एव। ड्यूरिंग द एक्सपीरियंस ऑल्सो आफ्टर दिस एक्सपीरियंस इट वुडंट लास्ट बिकॉज दिस विषय सुख विल गो अवे। दैट थिंकिंग इटसेल्फ विल व्याकुलोत्पादाने उत्पादानेन दुःख निदानम एव। इट विल मेक अ पर्सन व्याकुल वाइल इन वाई डू यू थिंक अबाउट टुमोरो। पीपल से वाई डू यू मिस आउट ऑन टूडे थिंकिंग अबाउट टुमोरो। एंजॉय वाइल इट लास्ट, बट अ पर्सन इज अनेबल टू एंजॉय, ही कीप्स ऑन थिंकिंग अबाउट प्लानिंग एंड थिंकिंग अबाउट द फ्यूचर। नो टुमोरो दिस पर्सन विल गो अवे, टुमोरो दिस थिंग वोंट बी देयर, समबडी इज गोइंग टू टेक इट अवे और इट वोंट लास्ट। थिंकिंग दैट दिस पर्सन इवन हैज दुख ड्यूरिंग द हैप्पीनेस एज वेल। वैषयिक सुख इज मिक्स्ड अप विद दुख। एवं च वैषयिकम सुखम सर्वम दुखेन कबलीकृतमेव वर्तते, मिश्रीकृतमेव वर्तते इत्यर्थः। इट इज ऑलवेज मिक्स्ड अप, द वैषयिक सुख इज ऑलवेज मिक्स्ड अप विद दुख। तस्माद् विषयजन्यम सुखम वस्तुतः स्वस्वरूपमपि विषयोपाधि संबंधात् दुखमेव। सो ड्यू टू दिस संबंध इट इज दुख एनी वे। ड्यू टू दिस विषयजन्य सुख वस्तुत इन रियालिटी इफ इंक्वायर इन टू दिस सुख, सुख स्वरूपमपि ऑल्दो इट इज जस्ट द मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ वन ओन स्वरूप आनंद स्वरूप सुख, स्टिल दैट सुख इज वस्तुतः वस्तुतः ऑल्दो स्वरूप सुख इन रियालिटी इट इज स्वरूप सुख, इट इज नथिंग एल्स, देर इज नो अदर सोर्स ऑफ आनंद, इट इज ऑलवेज आत्मा आनंद। Misplaced in Vishaya, therefore Vishayopadhi Sambandha Dukkham Eva. Since this Atmananda is manifest due to the Vishayopadhi Sambandha, therefore it is Dukkham. It is Swarupa Sukha, but it is not in its original ओरिजिनल फॉर्म विच इज नॉट मैनिफेस्ट, विच इज नॉट एक्सपीरियंसेबल, इट इज फोर्स टू बी मैनिफेस्ट बाई विषय उपाधि संबंध. वेन दिस विषय उपाधि संबंध टेक्स मैनिफेस्ट दिस स्वरूप सुख एज एक्सपीरियंशियल सुख, इट विल बी दुख. कंपेयर टू वॉट? कंपेयर टू स्वरूपानंद. इट मे अपियर टू बी सुख बट इट इज दुख मिश्रित एनी वे. सो इट इज दुखम एव. इफ यू एनालाइज यू वुड स्टे अवे फ्रॉम इंटेलिजेंस बिकॉज इट इज दुख रूप, दुख मिश्रित एटलीस्ट. सो भवति सर्वदा, इट्स पुट अ फुल स्टॉप देर, बट दुख दुखमेव भवति सर्वदा, ऑल टाइम्स इट इज जस्ट दुख. वैषयिक सुख इज नॉट रियली सुख जस्ट बिकॉज इट इज मैनिफेस्ट बाय विषय उपाधि संबंध. न च एतद् दुखम, इफ नथिंग एल्स सी वाई दुखम इन द लॉन्ग रन, इट विल कीप अ पर्सन इन संसार बाय इम्प्रेसिंग संस्कार. दैट इज द रीजन सर्वदा इट विल कीप वन गोइंग इन संसार. Thereby, dukkha rupa samsara will continue. Nacha etad dukkham kena chiddapi laukiko upayana pariharthum shakyate. The upayas which the Uropakshi has given, that you have so many ways to take away these dukkhas which are afflictions caused by the triad. Adhyatmika, adhibhautika, all of these adhidevika, adhyatmika, adhibhautika, adhidevika, all of these three triad are dukkha rupa, but they have solutions. So laukika upayena kena chidapi pariharthum na shakyate etad dukkham. This dukkha cannot be taken away. You apply Ayurveda to roga, sometimes it goes away, sometimes it doesn't go away. Even after the roga goes away, it comes back. You have other solutions. You do mantra japa, you take away the other sorts of adversities, dukkhas, they'll also come back if you stop the mantra japa. As long as the devata is pleased, that devata will help you out. After that, if you don't care for the devata, he doesn't care for you. In fact, having invoked him and not served him, he will start punishing you. This is a niyama. You invoke the Lord, you don't treat him well, you go to a temple, the Lord is invoked. In the deity, the Lord is invoked. If we go to the temple, there are people who chit-chat in the Garbhagudi. The Lord is invoked there. What kind of Shraddha will others have? The deity will start creating trouble. He is not invoked, he does not want to be invoked to listen to your chit-chat. He is invoked because you need him, and having given prana pratishtha, you are supposed to take care of him like you take care of a child. It is a give and take relation there. You have to respect the Lord the way he is invoked, not any which way. No, I am okay. I mean, all Advaita Tattva, but Advaita Tattva does not work in that Garbhagudi. You have to treat the Lord as the Lord. Otherwise, he will also treat you the way you have treated him. This many people do not understand. We have this temple, we pray, but then there are temple priests who use mobile phones in the Garbhagudi. Very unfortunate. Others do not have Shraddha. They also keep on chit-chatting there. When in the Homa also the Lord is invoked. In an invisible form, the Lord is invited. So we have to have Shraddha that the Lord is right there physically in the Sukshma Sharira, Sukshma Avastha. People do not have that, and they say that this, even if I do Havana, nothing works. Nothing works because people are not doing the Havana properly. It will work only with Shraddha. The Lord who is in invoked, he is treated well. He or she is treated well, the deity, the way it is invoked. Otherwise, laukika upayana parihartum na shakyate. You will have to continue doing that without any break. Otherwise, the dukkhas which are already earned, they won't be taken away. Thereby, completely they won't go away. Even if they go away, they'll come back. These dukkhas are, so to say, nitya in comparison, because they keep on coming back. उपायन्वेषण कुशलस्यापि निशेष दुख निवृत्तेर अदर्शनात्। वाई? बिकॉज दोज हु नो द उपायास एंड यूज द उपायास टिल दे ऑल्सो हैव दुखास, एवरीवन हैज दुखा। इवन अ ज्ञानी एज लॉन्ग एज देर इज शरीर देर इज शरीर कृत दुख, ही मे नॉट एसोशिएट बट दी दुख शरीर कृता इज देर। पीपल सी दट शरीर इज सफरिंग। निवृत्तम इव च सदपि पुनः उत्पद्यते एव। इवन इफ इट गोज अवे इट इज इव एज दो गॉन। निवृत्तम इव, निवृत्तम सत बट निवृत्तम सत इव, एज दो गॉन अवे, नॉट रियली गॉन अवे, इट विल कम बैक एज लॉन्ग एज यू आर ट्रीटिंग इट गोज अवे। यू नो इन प्लेसेस लाइक मुंबई इन समर यू आर टेकिंग अ शॉवर, ड्यूरिंग द शॉवर एज लॉन्ग एज द वॉटर इज कोल्ड you are fine, as soon as you switch off the shower you start sweating. Nivruttam iva, not really gone away. Sometimes the water is not cold enough and during the bath also you are sweating. Dukkha, you have the solution but useless solution, not working well. So laukika upayas won't take it away. Tataha yavat sharira sthitihi dukkhan na nivarteta iti viveko bhavati. So what is the step that follows? The viveka that is born out of these experiences and analyzing it, yava sharira sthiti dukkhan na nivarteta iti viveko bhavati, dukkha will not go as long as sharira is there. And the sharira is what? Not this sharira alone, future sharira is ready for me. As long as sanchita karma is there, future sharira is there. Prarabdha will be carved out, I'll get another sharira in keeping with the prarabdha due for fructification. So infinite prarabdhas are there to be carved out, waiting from this to be carved out from the sanchita. So those shariras also I have to think about, not this sharira alone. Yavat sharira sthiti dukkham tavanna nivartate, tavanna nivartate iti viveko bhavati, wouldn't go away. There is no possibility. Shakyarthe ling, there is not even a possibility. Nivarteta, not nivartate, nivarteta, not latlakara, vidhiling. Why vidhiling? Because shakyarthe, na nivarteta, not even possible. It is impossible that dukkha will go away. As long as sharira is there. Navai sa sharirasya sataha priya priyayor apahati rasti ashariram vavasantam na priya priye sprushataha iti. Iti shrute hai. So shruti is quoted, chandogya ashtodhyaya shruti says, mantra says that one who has sharira priya prayo apohati nasti, priya and apriya will continue. This gradations of sukha and gradations of dukkha will keep on continuing. Sasharirasya sharirena saha vartate iti sasharira tasya sasharirasya sataha. As long as it is there, this can also be taken as priyapriyo asti, it can be also taken as satashashti. So like sati saptami also it can be taken. As long as sharira is there, to understand the meaning, ashariram va vasantam, ashariram is not, you know, giving the sharira away physically. Cognitively you have to give up the sharira. Ashariram, there is the connection with the sharira due to tadatmya sambandha, which is due to ajnana, should be cut away. It should be broken and that person is asharira. Then ashariram va vasantam na priya priye sprishata. That kind of, when asharira person, priya and priya do not touch. Because cognitively is separated, he'll say guna guneshu vartante. The entire set of shariras is a product of ajnana. Ajnana karya, it is mahabhutas put together, pancha mahabhutas. I am separate from it, I am not put together. These are put together for me because I am a karta. I am forced to be a bhokta. If I drop my kartrutvam, bhoktrutvam will never associate with me. I have nothing to do with this priya priya vritti which are coming up in the sukshma sharira, which is not me. I am Sakshi Matra. I separate myself out and become an Ashariira. Ashariira. Thereby these do not touch that kind of an ashariram me. Sasharira sharira matrasya punya papa phalatvat shariranvaya vyatirekabhyam sukadukha sambandha tadabhavo shruyete. So in this shruti, what is heard? Two things are heard here. Sharira matrasya punya papa phalatvat, due to one associating with the sharira. What kind of a sharira? The sharira matra is not with me included. It is just the sharira. I am separate from the sharira. So that sharira matra, tasya sharira matrasya punya papa phalatvat. I am not born due to punya and papa. I am ajah brahma. I am ajah atma. I am ajah brahmatma. I am never born. But what is born? Punya papa phalatva. Punya phala and papa phala mixed up brings up this sharira. So sharira is born. I am not born. Sharira anve vyatireka abhyam sukadukha sambandha tadabhavo shruyete. So sharira anvaya and vyatireka. Through anvaya vyatireka, co-presence and co-absence. Sharira anvayena. Sharira anvayena sukha sambandha. Sukha dukha sambandha. Sharira anvayena sukha dukha sambandha shruyate. And sharira vyatirekena sukha dukha, that is tad. Tad abhava is sukha dukha abhava shruyate. So two things are known from Shruti. As long as sharira continues, sharira anvaya is there. Anuvritti of the sharira is a samsaranam is there. Because of ajnana continuing, sharira sambandha is there. Ajnana goes away, sharira sambandha goes away here and now. There may be sharira sambandha till the videha mukti, but jivan mukta has no sharira sambandha. Cognitively, there is no sambandha. So sharira anvayena, if it continues, sharira anvayena sukha dukha sambandha shruyate. Sukha dukha sambandha will be there because I consider myself as sharira or sharira as mine due to ahankara and mamakara. Sukha dukha which afflict the sharira, affect the sharira. Sukha helps the sharira. Sukshma sharira is included, not only stula sharira. Sukha dukha is in the sukshma sharira. Vrittis are there in the sukshma sharira. They can be due to the sukshma sharira itself, due to thoughts, smriti working, you know, planning for the future or analyzing the present or being lost in the past. All these are sukha or dukha karaka. Similarly, stula sharira also. Stula sharira may come into contact with everything that is around in any which way, and all sorts of sense organs are connected. Thereby, sukha or dukha can be there. Priya and apriya vrittis will continue. But when the sharira sambandha goes away, sharira vyatirekena, sukha dukha, tadabhava is sukha dukha abhava, abhavaha. Sukha and dukha abhava will be there. Because I have cognitively nothing to do with these shariras. When I have nothing to do with, then whenever there is sukha dukha, I can separate out myself. I know that Atma does not have sukha or dukha. And over a period of time, it will become natural. This cognition will become natural. This understanding will set in. There will be nitaram sthiti, nishtha in that. That Atma which has nothing to do with sharira, sharira matra is separate, and I am this Atma which has nothing to do with the anatma, sharira traya, and ajnana does not affect me, ajnana karya does not affect me. None of these shariras and their krita, sharira krita, doshas do not afflict me at all. So I remain in my own swarupa then. Tatra manushya shariram. Now this sharira is inquired into, what kind of shariras are you talking about? You are talking about Purvapakshi is, you have to imagine a Purvapaksha there. He says that you are thinking about manushya sharira, but I am a karmakandi. I can do upasana and get devata sharira. You are trying to avoid priya priya. I don't want to avoid priya. I want to avoid apriya. You are trying to avoid sukha dukha. I am trying to avoid dukha only. Why should I avoid experiential sukha? I will get that in swarga with a better upadhi. I will get that as a devata who has no dukha. Why would I want to avoid sukha? You take care of your own issues. I don't have such issues. This grantha is not useful because everyone wants to have sukha. You have agreed to it. Now you are saying sukha dukha sambandha abhava. Why would I want sukha sambandha abhava? I want only dukha sambandha abhava. I would get better shariras. So why should I avoid sharira? I should avoid only manushya sharira, which is dukkha rupa. With this thinking, now shariras are analyzed. What kind of shariras? Tatra manushya shariram tu punya papa mishra karma phalam iti prasiddhameva. Those who have studied some shastras, they know that manushya sharira is sukha dukkha, sorry, punya and papa mishra. There is approximately 50-50 punya and papa which gives rise to manushya sharira. And they say that 100% generally it is said in shastra that 100% punya will give you devata sharira and 100% papa. Meaning 100% papa ready to fructify in prarabdha. All this is in prarabdha. Sanchita has all sorts of mix. What is ready to fructify in that prarabdha? If there is a 50-50% mix of punya papa, one gets manushya sharira. If it is 100% punya devata sharira, 100% papa will give you adhogati, the prani sharira. Now this is a general understanding as per the shastra. Therefore, iti prasiddhameva. However, we know so far we have seen sadhu analyzes and he is interested in details. He says that is general. If you inquire, then you will know that it is not true. Deva shariram api mishra karma phalam iti eva vaktavyam. It is not true that devata sharira that you want will give you only sukha because it is not 100% punya krita. There is papa. The very idea that Janma takes place shows you that there is Papa Mishra. If you think that you will have no dukkha in Deva Sharira, then I suggest you study Purana says the Siddhanti. Deva Shariram api Mishra Karma Phalam ityeva Vaktavyam. Kevala Punya Phalatve tu Devanam Devantara Vibhutyatishaya Darshanena Na Tapo. There are other than devatas, there are so many. And devas, we know these devatas have trouble. The others trouble devatas also, rakshasas, asuras trouble them. Na tapo jayat. Had it been kevala punya phala, the sharira, devata sharira, then they wouldn't have tapa, dukkha rupa tapa from others. But they do have jayata iti, ki itihasa puranadishu kachyate. Study Purana, study Itihasas, you will know devatas run away every problem, they run away to Brahma, Chaturmukha Brahma. Then Brahma is sometimes unable to solve, they run to Vishnu. Sometimes Shiva has to play a role. So devata sharira also is papa karma mishrita. Kincha ashesha dev pradhana bhutasya api indrasya aneka daitya danavadibhyo bhayat mahad dukkham पाप फलभूतम जायत इति शास्त्रेण प्रतिपाद्यते. इफ यू स्टडी देन शास्त्र बाय शास्त्र इट इज रिवील्ड दैट दिस इंद्र हु हैज डन सो मेनी अग्निहोत्रास नॉट अग्निहोत्रास ही हैज डन सो मेनी अश्वमेधास 1000 अश्वमेधास गिव यू इंद्रत्व. इट इज अ पदवी दैट काइंड ऑफ इंद्र आल्सो और दोस काइंड ऑफ इंद्रास अक्रॉस कल्पास हैव सो मेनी इश्यूज. First of all, he has bhaya that someone else will take away my padvi. If someone comes to close to the count of Indratva phala, number of Ashwamedhas, if it keeps on increasing, then he'll start creating trouble because he does not want to be replaced. The love for the chair, the way politicians have, Indra also has. Yes, he has, he is the Utkrushta Devata, all right, but still he also has Dukkha, Bhayat. And Bhayat what? See, Daitya Danavadibhyo Bhayat, even Manushya can be added here. Manushya Bhaya is also there. Not only Daitya and Danava Bhaya, Indra also has Manushya Bhaya because that Manushya is trying to become Indra. And if another Indra is ready, this fellow will lose his Indratvam. Mahat Dukkham, not just simple Dukkha, Mahat Dukkha. Papa Phulam Phalabhutan Jayata. There cannot be Dukkha without Papa. So if Dukkha is there, Anyatha Anupapatya Papa has to be inferred. And if you know that Papa is there, Mishra, then that Devata Padvi will give you nothing. Even if you become Indra, it will give you Dukkha. Why would you say that I want Sukha through an Upadhi? So Siddhanti answers the Purvapakshi as, if you think that you will be okay, you will be perfectly fine, you will have only Sukha Sambandha with a Devata Sharira and you want to earn that, that will not work. Indra also has Dukkha. Mahat Dukkha, not only just Dukkha. Because now you have some Sukha which will go away, you have a little Dukkha. Imagine Indratva kind of Ananda, Sukha, and imagine that, the fear of that going away. It will be Mahat Dukkha. The more Sukha goes away, the more Dukkha it will leave behind. The more wanting, the more Dukkha will be there. Now this Manushya Sukha will not make you happy. Indra knows that. If I lose this Indratva, I may become a Manushya or another Devata or some Rakshasa or some Manushya or Adhogati also. I may become a Prani based on my Papa which may be pending. Nobody knows what is in Sanchita. We know that Sanchita is, you know, tending to infinity because we have earned it forever. Thereby Indra has this fear. This Indratva Sukha may go away. So there will be a lot of Dukkha. I don't want Manushya Sukha anymore now. I want only Indratva Sukha. That will bring in Mahat Dukkha. Yadi Deva Shariram Kevala Punya Phalan Syat Naiva Syat Kadachidapi Devanam Dukkham. There's a typo here. Devanam Dukkham Kadachidapi Naiva Syat. Had it been Punya Phalam, but there is Dukkha. Tasma Deva Shariram Api Punya Punya Mishra Karma Phalam Ityeva Nishchiyate. So it is ascertained, if you think without any bias, you'll know that Deva Sharira is also Papa Mishra Punya Krita. Then Nacha Nahavai Devan Papam Gachati Punyamevamum Gachati Ityadi Shrutehe Na Devanam Papa Sambandhosti Iti Vachyam. And you should not argue, says the Siddhanti. You, the Purva Pakshi, should not quote the Shruti, Brihadaranyaka Shruti, which says that Devas, the Papa does not approach Devas, only Punya approaches. You should not quote that because it has a different meaning there. You understand the context. Don't take one off sentence. It is Arthavada. There is some other context going on. Don't pick one and assume that, because Itihasa Purana shows that there has Dukkha. A Shruti quotation which is against the Shruti is Pramana, all right. But Shruti is Pramana for unknown Vishaya, not for known Vishaya. Itihasa Purana shows there is Dukkha for Devas. It is historical fact. Shruti cannot deny that. So this Shruti, even if you take it literally, it won't help because it has to be interpreted as Arthavada, because we know already that there is Dukkha for Devas from Itihasa Purana. So Shruti can't counter it. Its focus is somewhere else. Its focus is in Jnana. Everything else is need not be taken literally. It is not literal. May not be literal. Anya paratvat tasyaha shrutehe. It is committed to something else. You look at the context, you will know it is Jnana Kanda. It is not talking about Devas, Papas not being there. So do not argue in that manner, says the Siddhanti. Karmadikara yogyam shariram manusham meva netarat devatiryagadi shariram. And where does one have adhikara in karma? Only in manushya sharira. Ato devata sharirena kruta punya punya phalam janmantare na tan gacchati ityartha na tu tesham karma phalasya phalanam abhava. So karma phalabhava matram iti. It is not that they do not have karma phala abhava. Devata sharira is also punya and papa mix. Apunya is papa there. Janmantarena tan gacchati ityartha na tu tesham karma phala bhava matram iti. they will also, if devatatvam goes away, they'll have another janma. And in devata sharira also, they have this connection with dukkha also because of papa being there. Kintarhi deva shariropatte prag janmani shariraantara kruta shubha shubha karma phalam deva jati sharire anubhuyate eva. What it means is that the janmantarena tan gachati means whatever was due earlier, prag janmani deva shariropatte prag. The janmas which were there before the devata sharira prapti, shariraantara kruta shubhashubha karma phalam deva jati sharira anubhuyate eva. So they may not have anubhava of punya and papa which is generated in that janma of devata sharira, because punya and papa, punya kruta अतः देवता शरीर ने कृत पुण्य अपुण्य फलम जन्मांतरेण तान गच्छति. दे वोंट गेट अदर जन्मास. इट इज सेड इन देवताज वोंट गेट अदर जन्मास. व्हाट इज मेंट इज दैट दे वोंट गेट अदर जन्मास ड्यू टू दी पुण्य एंड पापा क्रिएटेड इन देवता शरीर. देवता शरीर मे नॉट लीड टू अनदर जन्म, बट देर इज मनुष्य शरीर विच वॉज देयर बिफोर द देवता शरीर. दे हैव अर्नड सो मेनी पुण्य एंड पापास इन दोज जन्मास. Some subset has led to devata janma, devata sharira. Does not mean that they will not get any janma. Earlier karma will fructify. This karma may not fructify because devata sharira may not generate anything. Ato devata sharirena kruta punya 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 phalam janmantarena tan gacchati ityartha natu tesham karma phalabhava matram iti किंतरी देव शरीरोत्पत्ते प्राग जन्मनि शरीरांतर कृत शुभाशुभ कर्म फलम देव जाति शरीरे अनुभूयते एव. सो दी पुण्य एंड पापा अर्नड अर्लियर विल गिव सुख एंड दुख इन दी देवता शरीर आल्सो, एंड इट वी शुड टेक इट अहेड एंड थिंक दैट इट कैन गिव अदर जन्माज आल्सो. तस्मात् देवादि शरीरमपि मिश्र कर्म फलमेव. सो देवादि शरीरमपि मिश्र कर्म फलमेव. Punya and Papa both are there. So this is the Devata Sharira. Now Tiryak Sharira, Pashu Pakshi, that is analyzed, that we know, but we'll look at this in the next part. Sukam Nityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Naam Rupe Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhir Rukyatva Nirmalam Aparam Sarvedanta Vedyam Pratyak Param Tadevahan Namattonyat Iti Menishitamatihi. Any questions? Yeah, I'll see you in the next part, huh? Namaste.